Hello, I am Krishna Raghavendran, and in this tutorial of MIT App Inventor, we are going to add splash screen to our app. So what is a splash screen? It is a screen that appears when you start an app. It is the first screen when you start an app. So we are going to add a splash screen to our app. So here are some examples of splash screens. So first, to add a splash screen, we are going to put a background image. So you can put any background you want. I'm going to put a gradient because that is the best background for a splash screen. So let's go to background image and let's upload a file. So here you can see I have gradient. Now it is uploaded and here you can see the gradient. Now we are going to put an icon. We are going to put the icon of the app at the middle of this screen. So to do that, we are going to bring the image, and now to bring this to the middle, we are going to click on the screen and we are going to put align horizontal and align vertical to be center. Now you can see that the image came to center. Now let's browse for the picture. So it's going to be the icon of the app. So I'm going to do a splash screen for a puzzle app. So this is the icon for my app. Let me upload it. Now it looks too big, so let's adjust the height and width. The height is going to be 30% and the width is going to be 30%. Now you can see it looks much smaller. Now we are going to put a label, and in this label we are going to put the name of the app. So in this case the name of the app is Puzzle App. Now let's make it bold, and we are going to increase the font size to be 30. Now we are going to put a text color to be white. Now let's bring another label. In this label we are going to put the version of the app. So every splash screen will have the version of the app. So I'm going to put the version to be 1.5. And now let's put the bag text color to be white. Next, we are going to add a progress bar to our splash screen. So to put a progress bar, we are going to put a slider here. And let's change the width of the slider to be 50% so that it looks much bigger like this. And then let's put the max value to be 100. And the minimum value can be 0. Now let's put the thumb position to be 0. So if I put thumb position as 50, you can see that it came to the middle, the progress bar. So it is half done loading the app. Now we are going to put the thumb position to be 0 because when the app is starting, it should be 0. Now let's put the thumb enabled. Let's uncheck this box. Now let's go to the sensors section and we are going to bring clock component. Now let's go to the block section. So from the clock, let's bring when clock 1.timer do. So inside this block we are going to increment the thumb value of the slider by 1. So to do that, let's put the thumb position. So set slider 1.thumb position 2 to increment it, we are going to add 1. So here we will get the thumb position value, and then from the math blocks we are going to put the addition operator. So slider 1.thumb position plus 1. Now so that when the timer is running, the value will increment by 1. And then if the value reaches 100, then we are going to move to the main screen of the app, which is going to be screen 2. This screen. So here we are going to put an if condition. So if the thumb value is equal to 100, which means the progress bar is full. So here we have the equal to operator. Let's put the slider 1.thumb position. So if it is equal to 100, then we are going to go to the next screen. So to do that, from the control section, we are going to put open another screen name. So here we are going to put the name of the screen. So here the name of the screen is screen 2. So let's put screen 2 here. Now if you want to, so if you reduce the timer interval, then the splash screen will be faster. It will go to screen 2 much faster. So I'm going to put the time interval to be 1 so that it is very fast. So here you can see the splash screen. And now you can see it went to screen 2. Now let me show it to you again. You can see the splash screen. And you can see the progress bar and the app title and the app version. And then after the progress bar is full, it goes to the next screen, which is screen 2. So do you want to create more mobile apps like this? I have put many tutorials on creating apps using MIT App Inventor in my channel. So you can check out my channel and subscribe. Thank you.